kids. I found this Lego set. It seems pretty cool, but seems rather tricky. The instructions are a little bit hard to follow. I'll finish this later.
Welcome to church. My name's Maddie, and I'm really glad you're here. Here at River City Kids, our mission is leading kids into a growing relationship with Jesus. And we do that by using the Bible. The Bible's God's rescue plan. Wait a second. What do we need rescuing from? What is it? You're right, it's sin. Sin is, well, do it with me. Sin is anything we think, say, or do that breaks God's law or makes him sad. Good job. Sin separates us from God, and that's why God sent his son Jesus to die on the cross to save us from our sins. And if we pray and ask God to forgive us of the things that we've done wrong, he does. He forgives us because he loves us. He actually loves us so much that he's building and creating us to be the person he wants us to be. Oh, that reminds me of our new series. Blueprint. This month is all about blueprints. Blueprints are the plans or the outlines of how to build something. Just like God is building us and creating us to who he wants us to be. All right, let's do the memory verse for the month. Jeremiah 29:11. Say it with me like this. Jeremiah 29:11. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord. Plans to prosper you, not to harm you. Plans to give you hope and a future. Good job. All right, let's do some worship.
And dance, God, Jesus said, cause I'm feeling it. Yeah, cause if this is what we believe, then it's time for us to get down. So I sing, you sing, I sing, you sing. Everybody come on. I believe it.
Come on.
Our Bible story today talks about God having the perfect plan. Let's open up to John chapter 2 and start in verse 13. It was almost time for the Jewish Passover feast, so Jesus went to Jerusalem. Passover is a time where Jewish people remember what God had done for them. They look back at their time in Egypt and they remember how terrible they were treated there. But then they celebrate that God had a plan for them and that God led them out of Egypt. Many people traveled from far away to celebrate the Passover. Even Jesus traveled to Jerusalem to celebrate in the temple. Let's keep reading and find out what happened when Jesus arrived. In the temple courtyard, he found people selling cattle, sheep, and doves. Others were sitting at the table exchanging money. Once Jesus arrived at the temple, Jesus saw that things were not going the way that God had planned them. Let's see what Jesus did about it. So Jesus made a whip out of ropes. He chased all the sheep and cattle from the temple area. He scattered the coins of the people exchanging money. Jesus was so upset that he made a whip and shoot out all of the animals from the temple. And he even tipped over tables to show how displeased he was. Then he said, "Get these things out of here! How dare you turn my father's house into a market?" Jesus was so upset that he made everyone leave the temple. Then people started to wonder, what power does he have to make everyone leave? Then Jesus answered, "Destroy this temple. I will raise it up again in 3 days." This was super confusing for everyone because the temple took 46 years to build, and Jesus just said that he would rebuild it in just 3 days. They had to have been thinking, this is impossible. With that one answer, Jesus was sharing about the plan that God had. Now, it wasn't about building a temple, but it was about later on that Jesus would die on the cross for everyone's sins, and just 3 days later, he would rise again. Now that's the perfect plan. All right, now it's time to see what Carl has to say about our Bible story for today.
Hi there, little chicken nuggets. It's me, Carl.
And I'm Andy, and welcome to Grow TV.
Hi, welcome.
Welcome to Grow TV, hosted by Carl, where we have fun with our friends, talk about Jesus, and go over everything the Bible has to offer. Now once again, welcome to Grow TV.
So Carl, guess what I did today?
You became a licensed therapist.
Nope.
You became the number one artist on country music charts.
Nope.
Did you... Wait. No.
What?
There's no way! You couldn't have.
What?
Did you undergo surgery to replace your human heart with a tortoise heart so you could live twice as long?
Yes. Yes, I did.
What? Are you serious?
No. I did something almost just as cool. I got us a plan.
What? Like a firm?
No, not a plant, a plan. And it's plans to build something extremely cool. The biggest paper airplane to ever exist.
What? You know the thing I love more than airplanes is paper. This is great. So what do we have to do?
Well, like I said, I have the plans right here. So all we have to do is follow the plans perfectly and then voila, we have the perfect paper airplane.
Seriously? That's it? Let's look at the plans. All right.
Here it is, right? It's just right in here, right in here. Here we go. Anywhere.
That's right a
here.
Lot of plans.
Yeah. Right there. It's not that big, right?
Wow. Is that all?
Yep.
All right. Well, it kind of looks a little confusing, but I guess we can give it a shot.
Let's do it.
Yeah. All right, I'm gonna say it. This is kind of a weird paper airplane.
Now, I don't think this is what it's supposed to look like.
I know that, Andy.
Maybe we should try it again.
There's no point, this plane is junk. Why can't my life be more like Jesus?
What do you mean by that?
Well, Jesus never had planes fall through like this.
Well, that's not true. Do you remember the story about Jesus getting angry in the temple?
It sounds familiar. What happened?
Well, Jesus was going to Jerusalem to go to the temple, and he found out people weren't sticking to the plan.
Wait, whose plan?
God's.
Oh. What were they doing?
Oh, where they were exchanging money and they were selling animals.
Well, was that bad?
Well, not technically, but they were doing it in the temple, which means they should have been celebrating the Passover instead.
All right, hold on. You lost me. Passover?
It was a time where all the Jewish people would come together in the temple and they would celebrate the time and remember the time that God delivered all the Israelites out of Egypt.
Oh, got it. So them selling and exchanging things on the Passover wasn't part of the plan or God's plan.
Exactly. And when Jesus got really upset, he started to turn over the tables and tell everyone to leave. But some of the people were wondering why Jesus even thought he had the authority to tell them to leave.
Oh, good. Question the Son of God. That's a good move.
So Jesus told them that he would destroy the temple and then rebuild it 3 days later. A lot of people got confused when he said that.
I can imagine. I know he's like Jesus and everything, but building that temple in that short time? I mean, that'll at least take, I don't know, 7 to 10 business days?
Well, it actually took them 46 years to build the temple, but that's not the point Jesus was trying to make. Jesus was trying to tell them that he was the plan going forward, that their old plans weren't what they should be trusting in.
Well, what old plans?
The ones where they try to fix all of the brokenness on their own. When Jesus said he was gonna rebuild the temple in 3 days, he was talking about himself. He said he had the power to bring himself back to life after 3 days, and his life would bring everyone else life.
Wow, so Jesus was talking about his life would be exchanged for ours the whole time.
Yes, and to put it simply, Jesus was hinting at God's big plan.
Wait, so Jesus dying for our sins was God's plan?
Sure was. It was the only way we could receive forgiveness and repair our relationship with God.
Holy moly, that's wild. So I guess God's plan did work out the way it was supposed to, unlike our paper airplane.
Exactly, and that's why I wanted to tell you this story. God's plan never fails.
Like Jesus, right?
What?
Like God's plan never failed for Jesus, but for others it might fail sometimes, right?
No, God has a specific and unique plan for each and every person out there, and it's better than any plan we could ever make for ourselves.
So God's plan is nothing like the paper airplane plan.
Nothing. God's plan is perfect.
Wow! Speaking of perfect, that's our big idea!
What?
Today's big idea is God's plans are perfect.
So let's say it out loud on the count of three. One,
two,
three.
God's plans are perfect!
Yeah, they sure are. God has a perfect plan. It is perfecto. That is Spanish for perfect.
Yep.
Bilingual.
Yay.
See.
So I'm really sorry I got your hopes up about the airplane plans. I really thought it would be, you know, cool. It just was confusing.
No worries. I couldn't understand it either.
Yeah.
Wait a minute.
What?
Oh no. It was upside down the whole time!
Oh.
We are foolish.
Okay, well.
You led me astray.
See you next week, kids. Sorry. I apologize.
It's fine.
I didn't know.
That paper airplane would have been super cool if Carl and Andy could have followed the blueprints to make it work. But they did say our big idea. God's plans are perfect. I think Miss Caitlin was just looking at some blueprints. Let's go over there and take a look.
Hi, Ruby City Kids. Good to see you today. I was just looking at this picture. It's a blueprint, and I just am having trouble figuring out what it is a picture of. What do you guys think that is? Oh, I got it. It's the blueprints for Cinderella's castle at Disney World. Wow, this is really complicated, huh? There's no way I could build something like that just by looking at this blueprint. Because look, this is what it actually looks like. Cinderella's castle. That looks nothing like the blueprint. These pictures show the same thing, but it takes very special instructions to get from this to this. In our lives, sometimes blueprints are confusing, and that's why we use instructions to get to them. We rely on God to give us instructions because God's plans are perfect. So I have a verse I'm going to read. It's Psalms 19, 7 to 11. It says, "The law of the Lord is perfect, reviving the soul. That means it turns us back to what is right. The decrees of the Lord are sure, making wise the simple. That means it gives us wisdom. The precepts of the Lord are right, rejoicing the heart. That means it brings us joy. The Bible brings us joy. The commandment of the Lord is clear, enlightening the eyes. That means the Bible shows us what God wants us to see. The fear of the Lord is pure, enduring forever. That means the Bible is going to last forever. The ordinance of the Lord are true, the right and righteous altogether. That means we can depend on the word in the Bible. More to be desired than they are gold, even much fine gold, sweeter than honey and drippings of honeycomb. That means this is really valuable, more than anything else. Moreover, by them is your servant warned. In keeping them, there is great reward." That means two things. It means, number one, we need to listen to it. It's a warning. And it's a promise that we need to believe it. So no matter what, we can trust God's word and God's plans because they're both perfect. They'll never lead us to a, God will never lead us to a plan that isn't good for us because God's plans are perfect. Bye, guys.
That was pretty cool that those tough to read blueprints became something amazing. Sometimes we go through tough times, and even in those tough times, God has a plan for us. Actually, the Bible is God's blueprints for our life, and we can trust that it will guide us through any tough time we face. Let's pray together. Dear God, thank you for showing us your plans through the word that you have given us. We trust that your plans are perfect and that they will give us hope even when things aren't going great. Help us to follow your plans. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, guys. Well, I'm going to get back to making my Lego creation. Make it a great... I almost forgot! We have to announce the River City Kid Challenge winner! Drum roll, please. The boys! The boys won! Woohoo, boys! Way to go, boys and girls. You guys were not far behind. All right, boys, if you want your prize, ask the adult in your house to email me so that I can get it to you. Make it a great day. All right, where are those blueprints? The blue piece, okay.